Welcome to the video, and I want to talk about cancer immunotherapy, but particularly I want to talk about intratumoral immunotherapy. You know, immunotherapy for cancer is really one of the most exciting things that we've seen, but it has a lot of limitations. And intratumoral immunotherapy actually, I think, has a lot of the solutions to the problems. One of the issues is that for immunotherapy, you need to be able to target the cancer in many different directions. And when you're using systemic immunotherapy, so intravenous, drugs like Opdivo and Keytruda, these drugs are going all throughout your body, so they're affecting immune cells everywhere. But where you really want to have the effect is where the cancer is at. You want those immune cells to be able to learn and see and attack the cancer. Of course, cancer is a very formidable foe, and it can change. You block a particular receptor, such as like in the PD-1 receptors, and it'll express other receptors and will suppress the immune response. And so we need to hit it with many angles. And to go and to fight cancer with a single agent, or even two or three agents, is like saying you're going to go to war, but you're only going to use one branch of the armed forces. Or even more so, you're saying, well, we're only going to use one type of gun. I mean, that's just impossible for any enemy to fight. And cancer is really intelligent. And I think that this intratumoral immunotherapy is going to allow us lots of combinations. We're already using numerous combinations that you can never use in patients systemically. If you use these extensive combinations, the patients have tremendous side effects. But yet, when you inject into the tumor, you can use lots of combinations with very little problems because you're making the effect right where the tumor is, right where you want it to learn. Now, of course, sometimes in cancer, patients have tumors in different locations, and some of those locations behave a little bit differently. And so you may have to target different areas. But I want to dispel one myth with intratumoral immunotherapy. People think that that only treats the tumor you inject, but that's not the case. Intratumoral immunotherapy is where you're treating locally, but you're acting globally. You're actually teaching the immune system in that one location, but it can go out to other areas of the body and attack the cancer. And so this really is a very exciting development, and I think that this will be the future of all cancer therapy, including other things like people are very excited about tumor-infiltrating lymphocytes and CAR T. But even those actually have a huge potential to be injected directly into the tumor. And so we really need to be able to go and attack these directly. So there's lots of advantages. Of course, you use less drugs, less total drugs, even though there may be numerous combinations. So in theory, the cost can be less, the side effects are less, the treatment time is actually faster, instead of patients needing to get intravenous infusions every 2 or 3 weeks. This can be done over sometimes a single injection, sometimes over several injections. And the other thing is that patients wonder, okay, well, I'm getting chemotherapy, I'm getting systemic immunotherapy like Opdivo or Keytruda. When is the right time for intratumoral immunotherapy? That's another huge advantage. It can always be added in to any particular treatment, since it's well tolerated. So if a patient's getting chemotherapy, there's no reason that you can't inject the tumors with immunotherapy. And if the patient's getting systemic immunotherapy, injecting the tumors enhances the response even more. Now, of course, there's different degrees. For example, some studies have indicated that injecting simple things such as vaccines, like the flu vaccine or the rotavirus vaccine, into tumors can enhance the immune response of medications like Opdivo and Keytruda. So for patients getting these systemic immunotherapies, you think, well, why would you not do that? I mean, it's very simple. It's going to enhance the response. We know that immunotherapy is a great development, but unfortunately, you know, the drugs like Opdivo and Keytruda still fail the majority of the time, and most patients are only looking at extension of life expectancy. And obviously we want better than that. And I think that injecting these tumors is really the key, and using that in conjunction with these other therapies is certainly a nice first step. I think in the future, we'll get it all through, you know, a single injection or maybe two or three injections for the patients. But intratumoral immunotherapy really is the most exciting thing in cancer treatment. And I think that it's the treatment that's going to lead ultimately to a cure for cancer. I thank you for your attention, and I hope that you like our page and follow us. Thank you.